Well, if you're looking for a doctor, look no place else than Baltimore Magazine, because the top doc's issue is out, and Ken Eigelhart is here to tell us all about it. Thanks for coming in.
Good morning. Thanks for having us in.
You're welcome. This is a big deal that you guys do every year.
The doctors
really look forward to
this. A lot of egos out there.
Yeah.
It's important to them.
How do you come up with this list?
It's a very large survey that it takes about 6 months. We mail several thousand surveys by U.S. mail to names chosen at random among physicians who are licensed to practice in Maryland. And then we also have an online survey. Mm-hmm. So we get two sets of results coming in, and the participation is actually growing. So we're able to be pretty picky in each specialty. I mean, we only take the top few voted mm-hmm. by their peers as the best.
Okay, let's go down the list of some that you all that made the list. Dr. Stephen Bartlett.
Yeah, we did a story on him to accompany this list. Mm-hmm. He's a very famous transplant surgeon at the University mm-hmm. of Maryland. And what we focused on in this story was an amazing face transplant that he did on a poor fellow that had a misunderstanding with a shotgun. And but there was an extra angle to this, that he did some bone marrow transplant from the donor mm-hmm. to prevent rejection that could end up being key in future transplants of all kinds.
Right, right. Okay. Dr. Ryan Katz.
Ryan Katz. That's an interesting story. A policeman, Eastern Shore, Hurricane Irene, powers out. He gets on a ladder to fix a leak, falls, his thumb catches in the ladder, rips the whole thumb off, tendons and all, and he's rushed to the local hospital, which is, you know, can't do anything. They take him to Curtis National Hand Center at Union Memorial, which, you know, specializes mm-hmm. in this. And to make a long story short, they can't save the thumb, so they remove his toe mm-hmm. and sew it in there and vascularize it, and then they do cosmetic surgery on it so it looks like a thumb.
And functions like
And functions, thumb. And this was a retired police officer, and finally, just this a couple months ago, he was able to go back to service.
Wow.
So he can shoot a gun, put mm-hmm. cuffs on, and chase suspects and do everything he could do before.
Wow, that's amazing.
Yeah.
All right, Dr. Shine and Goldstein.
Dr. Shine and Goldstein, this was an amazing thing. There's a guy named Hinman who's the founder of Jiffy Lube and lives mm-hmm. in the area on a horse farm and loves horses. Going blind because of macular degeneration, mm-hmm. Getting very depressed about it. Goes to Wilmer Eye at Hopkins, and they implant basically a bionic little telescope in one eye that magnifies everything 2.5 times. And so now he can watch his horses, and he can read, and he can recognize his friends again. So it's, you know, pretty amazing technology.
That's amazing that we've got these talented doctors right here in our backyard, or right here. All right, Dr. Singh.
Dr. Singh, this was an interesting story. This was a woman named Carol Ferranti. She was a gym teacher at a Howard County public school. Mm-hmm. She weighed 307 pounds. And obviously she was having some depression issues. And but the final moment for her was going to an amusement park. This was on a trip with her kids, mind you.
Wow.
And an announcement comes over the loudspeaker from the operator of the big ride saying, "Lady, you're too fat. You have to get off the ride." I mean, think of the humiliation.
That is humiliating.
So that just drove her to go get bariatric surgery. And she was she's a wonderful lady and, mm-hmm. you know, very open about her thing. Mm-hmm. And, you know, gave us a great story about exactly what's involved there and what a huge difference it makes in her life.
Okay. And who's this doctor in the front?
This is a doctor from Hopkins, Maria Olivia Hemkert, mm-hmm. Who's pediatric gastroenterology at Hopkins Children's Center.
She has a nice picture there.
Yeah.
Okay, and so people want, they can read more about the top doctors in this month's issue of Baltimore Magazine that's on newsstands.
Yes, and there's also a great commemorative of JFK and what people of different generations, how they react to, you know, to his loss.
Oh, wow. Okay. Look forward to reading all of it.
Yeah.
Thank you for your hard work.
Thanks for having us on the show.